Assalamu alaikum students, how are you? I hope you'll be fine. Today we'll study the remaining story, The Machine Stops. No, I do not. I dislike the stars. But did they give you an idea? How interesting, tell me. I had an idea that they were like men. I do not understand. The four big stars are the man's shoulders and his knees. The three stars in the middle are like the belts that men wore once, and the three stars hanging are like a sword. A sword? Men carried swords about with them to kill animals and other men. It does not strike me as a very good idea, but it is certainly original. When did it come to you first? In the airship. He broke off, and she fancied that he looked sad. She could not be sure, for the machine did not transmit nonsense of expression. It only gave a general idea of people, an idea that was good enough for all practical purposes. Vashti thought the finer details of expression was rightly ignored by the machine, just as the finer detail of the grape was ignored by the manufacturers of artificial fruit. Something good enough had long since been accepted by our race. The truth is, he continued, that I want to see these stars again. They are curious stars. I want to see them not from the airship, but from the surface of the earth, as our ancestor did thousands of years ago. I want to visit the surface of the earth. She was shocked again. Mother, you must come, if only to explain to me what is the harm of visiting the surface of the earth. No harm, she replied, controlling herself, but no advantage. The surface of earth is only dust and mud. No life remains on it, and you would need a respirator, or the cold of the outer air would kill you. One dies immediately in the outer air. I know, of course, I shall take all precautions. And besides, well, she considered and chose her words with care. Her son had an odd personality, and she wished to dissuade him from the expedition. It is contrary to the spirit of the age, she asserted. Do you mean by that contrary to the machine? In a sense, but his image in the blue plate faded. Kyono? He had isolated himself. For a moment, Vashti felt lonely, then she generated the light, and the sight of her room, flooded with radiance and studded with electric buttons, revived her. There were buttons and switches everywhere, buttons to call for food, for music, for clothing. There was the hot bath button by pressure of a basin of marble rose out of the floor, filled to the brim with a warm, deodorized liquid. There was the cold bath button. There was the button that produced literature, and there were, of course, the buttons by which she communicated with her friends. The room, though it contained nothing, was in touch with all that she cared for in the world. Vashti's next move was to turn off the isolation switch, and all the accumulations of the last 3 minutes burst upon her. The room was filled with the noise of bells and speaking tubes. What was the new food like? Could she recommend it? Has she had any ideas lately? Might one tell her one's own ideas? Would she make an engagement to visit the public nurseries at an early date, say this dream month? To most of these questions, she replied with irritation, a growing quality in that accelerated age. She said that the new food was horrible, that she could not visit the public nurseries through press of engagements, that she had no ideas of her own but had just been told one, that four stars and three in the middle were like a man. She doubted there was much in it. Then she switched off her correspondence, for it was time to deliver her lecture on Australian music. The clumsy system of public gatherings had been long since abandoned. Neither Vashti nor her audience stirred from their rooms. Seated in her armchair, she spoke, while they, in their armchairs, heard her. fairly well and saw her fairly well. Her lecture, which lasted 10 minutes, was well received, and at its conclusion, she and many of her audience listened to a lecture on the sea. There were ideas to be got from the sea. The speaker had donned a respirator and visited Italy. Then she fed, talked to many friends, had a bath, talked again, and summoned her bed. The bed was not to her liking. It was too large, and she had a feeling for a small bed. Complaint was useless, for beds were of the same dimensions all over the world, and to have had an alternative size would have involved vast alterations in the machine. Vashti isolated herself. It was necessary, for neither day nor night existed under the ground, and reviewed all that had happened since she had summoned the bed last. Ideas, scarcely any. Events, was Cuno's invitation an event? Should she take an airship and visit him? So students, you are to read this story very carefully, and after reading this story and consider it a comprehension. Part A is related to comprehension. Answer the following questions. You are to answer these questions, and you will search your answers from the story after reading. First question is, who are Vashti and Cuno? They are mother and son. Vashti is a lady and Cuno is her son. In this way, you are to search all the answers of these given questions from your story. Thank you.